Hello guys, and welcome to today's tutorial video. In today's tutorial video, we're going to focus on adding a new company using a setup assistant on Sage Pastel desktop software. We're going to utilize the following example, which says Mr. Marvin is the owner of ShopLeft, a company that is operating in the retail industry. ShopLeft sells various product types, including appliances, food and drinks, clothes, stationery, etc. The company was formed 3 years ago with an investment that is a share capital of 1 million rands. Then it says the share capital remained the same until the 23rd of October 2020, when the new shares were issued. And then they here tell us that the ShopLeft has been running for 3 years and decided to convert to Pastel Partner for their transaction processing. Okay, from that short paragraph, we can pick up that the chart of accounts that the company is going to be using is the retail chart of accounts, which is the general ledger accounts, because it's operating in the retail industry. That's why you see that I bolded the retail there. And then again, one thing to note is that Mr. Marvin started this company with a share capital of 1 million rands. So that is another thing that we're going to have to process as an opening balance for the current year 2020. And then another thing that I have bolded here, as you can see, is that the new shares were issued on the 23rd of October 2020. So we're going to have a new tutorial video that is going to be uploaded. You can just search for it in the channel, or it is there outlined in the top left corner there. The new share issue. So there's going to be a separate tutorial video dealing with how to record or process the new share issue transaction. And then the information that we're going to use is that we are required to use the setup assistant to create a ShopLeft Pty Ltd on Pastel Partner with a 28 February 2021 financial year. Okay, then now the information that we're going to use is outlined from point number 1 to point number 7. The first point says that the postal address of the company is that, and then we have the company registration number and the VAT. Then the third one, we have the date sequence that we have to use, and then the fourth one, it tells us that the start date of the financial year is 1 March 2020. That is very understandable, because the financial year end, as you can pick up right here, is the 28 February 2021. All right. Then point number 5 says ShopLeft uses three cash books, namely VBank, iBank and PettyCash, to pay for small expenses. And then the other one says the default terms for customers are 30 days after the period. And then we are told that the company uses what? Balance forward. And then the last point says the company has two price lists, namely individual and wholesale prices. So as you know that with wholesale prices is normally those companies that sell in large quantities. Normally they sell to retail companies. So there's different prices for individuals and wholesalers. All right, and on the top, on the bottom right corner, I have outlined the methods of creating a new company on Sage Pastel Accounting. We can see that you can create a new company using Setup Assistant, which is a guided series of steps. That is the method that we're going to use for this particular purposes. And then the second one says create from backup. The third says start new company. And the fourth one says copy another company. Okay, fine. Without waste of time, let's go and create this particular company on Sage Pastel Accounting. So we're going to open Sage Pastel Accounting. As you can see, I had it open already and placed it on a demo company. So for us to create a new company, we'll have to go to File tab. When you get to File tab, you need to create, click on New. Then as you can see, we're going to have this screen that is open right now. And then on the method, we have to select the appropriate method that we are using. There it is, Setup Assistant. And right there, it is recommended that you put the name of the company and the financial year it relates to, because that will just be the name of the folder that will be located in your C drive. It might be any other drive, depending on the specifications of your own device. So in my device, it's defaulted in local disk C, which normally by default, Sage Pastel Accounting defaults to this drive. So right now I have Pastel 18. So the company that I create here will be located in this folder, Pastel 18, with the name that I dedicate here. So I'm just going to insert the name of this particular, but I'm just going to say Shop L 21 to reflect that it relates to the financial year ended 2021. Then I'm going to click on Create. Once you click on Create, you'll notice that it will take you to this screen, which is the first now that they say there are maximum of 12 screens in this assistant, including this screen. So meaning that this is the first guided screen out of 12. Now here you just need to select the country the company is located in. So here I'm going to select South Africa. And here now, this is where you can insert the full name of the company. So this is where I'm going to insert the name of the company, which is Shoplift Pty Ltd. Now we are given the address as PO Box 7489, Mother City 1.7, and then there is the telephone number. So I'm just going to go and copy that and paste it on our address. Mother City 1.7. Then we have the postal code as 1.7. Then there we go. Then on additional information now, we'll check if we have any additional information relating to the company. For instances, we have the telephone number here as given. So I'm just going to copy it as well, and on additional information, the first line, I'm going to insert that. So what you need to notice is that, or what you need to keep in mind is that the third line is normally reserved for company registration number, and the fifth line is normally reserved for VAT registration number. So I'm just going to copy that respectively and insert them there. There we go, we have company registration number. Then we have VAT registration number as that. We have company VAT registration number Then I'm just go when you are done, you click on next. Then this will be the third screen out of 12. Now here you can just read this short sentence here if you want to get clarity of what this screen entails. But here you just have to insert choose the date sequence, and you have to choose also the format of the year. So if I go to our example, it says that the date sequence should be DMY, and then we should use 4 digits per year. So I'm going to select DMY, day is selected, day, month, and a year. Then 4 digits per year. And then there you just have to select the separator that is preferred. Then you're going to click on next when you are done. Then on the fourth screen, this is where you have to set the period, your period. And you need to be careful here because you just have to set only one period, which is the starting period. Remember, in a financial year, we have 12 periods, meaning we have 12 months. Or in other cases, we can have 13 months. But for these purposes, we're going to use 12 months. So the first period we are given here is 1 March 2020. So we are going to use that as given. It's going to be 2020, 1 March 2020. Then there we go. And then you need to indicate when each period ends. Then it says it ends on the last day of the month. Then you will select whichever one that is relevant. Then you're going to click on next when you are done. Click on next. Then on the next screen now, you need to select the number of periods. This just means that you need to select the number of months that the company uses. Normally, if the company uses 13 period, you need to select use last period as the first period of the year, so that the 13th period is going to be used as the first period as well. But the most common one, we know that the financial year has or contains 12 months. So you're going to use 12 periods and click on next when you're done. Then now on the following screen, you need to select the type of general ledger accounts that the company is using. So now, looking at this example of ours, we are told that the company is operating in the retail industry. So meaning that the general ledger accounts need to relate to those that are found in the retail industry. So we're going to select retail. There we have retail. And if you look there, we have as many industries as possible that you can select from. For example, if you go to, let's go to farming and see what farming contains. If you look at the general ledger accounts that are found under farming, you'll notice that these are the accounts that are related to farming activities. Like for example, sales from cattle, sales from sheep wool, sales from fruit, all those relate to the results or the products of farming activities. So we're going to select our retail and click on next when you are done. Then now on this screen, we now need to insert or create our cash books. So remember that we were told that the company uses 3 cash books: VBank, iBank, and PettyCash. So we need to set 3 there as the number of cash books to create. Then you click on tab. Then you need to insert the names of those banks. So the first one is going to be iBank, and then they say that I bank 1, 2, 3, and then V bank 2, 3, 4. There's going to be I bank 1, 2, 3. The other one is going to be V bank 2, 3, 4. Then the last one is going to be our petty cash. Then when you are done, you click on next. Then the following screen says we need to create inventory price lists. So now we were told that the company uses only two price lists, and the most common one is individual. So we just need to insert those price lists, individual and wholesale. Then when you are done as well, we're going to click on next. The following screen now is based on the terms, which is how long the customers are expected to take before paying the company. So now if we go to our example, that says on point number 6, default terms for customers are 30 days after the reporting period, and we need to use the balance forward. Then you're going to go back and click it's period based, and they're expected to take only 30 days for them to pay their debt. Then you click on next. Then the next screen now, it talks about the customer defaults. So we were told on our example that the company elected to use the balance forward method. You can read these three little paragraphs if you need to know what each of them entail, or what is the customer defaults and what's happening in this screen. When you are done, you're going to click on next. Then here you just need to create or select the paper style. So we can see that the one that is created or selected here is pre-printed single sheet. So we're just going to leave it on this one. And then when you are done, you have to then process your company. Then once you click on process, it will set up your company, and when it's done, you can click on finish. Then you are done with setting your company. Then you just need to go through these little steps of creating password for your company and the backup question if, for example, you forget your password. Then you can use the security question and the security answer in order to go back into your company. Then I'm just going to create a short password right there, and then the security answer, I'm just going to say module. Security answer, I'm just going to say computer. Then I'm going to click on OK. Then it says there is no email address that is completed for the user profile. Remember, this is going to be the user, the first user for your company. You are the first user for your company, the company that you are setting up. So I don't want to create any email address for this person right now. So I'm going to click on no. Then it says the company has been set up with the, or what did this email. Then this marks the end of this tutorial video. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing for more beneficial videos coming.
Thanks for watching. A like would be appreciated. And don't forget to subscribe.